Now we have the campaign manager of the Lacson-Soto tandem, former Secretary Ronaldo Puno. Mr. Puno, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen.
All right.
Thank you for having us.
To the point. Some say you have Senator Ping Lacson, who's the most experienced, right? And even most qualified. I've heard people say that. But the surveys don't seem to show it. You know, what will you do? How will you, what kind of strategy will you use to actually let people see that he is qualified, if not the most qualified, to be president as some claim?
Yeah. Well, let's remember first what the surveys are, no, Karen. These are slices of time, no? And we measure the opinions and thoughts of people at given points in time. If you go back, for example, to March of last year, Bongbong Marcos was at 13%, Sara Duterte was about 25%. In June of last year, Bongbong Marcos was still 13 and Sara was 28, I believe. Mm. In September, Bongbong Marcos was 15 and Sara was about 25. Mm. And then in December, Bongbong Marcos was 53. Mm. So there's that you know, huge gap between September and December. So people ask, so what happened? You know, there's this story going around that it's his strong social media campaign, which, as we all know, is a robust one. Pero was that enough to bring him up 30 points or more? I don't think so.
That's a good one. What do you think?
Well, I think, you know, again, another thing you will see in the service, this has been consistent. 75% of our population are feeling secure. They're happy. They don't think there's anything bad that's going to happen. They're hopeful that the next year will be better. They think their lives will improve. So, you know, unlike other elections, this election is not an election about change. Okay? Nice. People are not going to try to change stuff. This is about continuity. I think the messaging needs to be that, you know, our candidate will keep you secure. Whatever keeps you hopeful will remain in your lives in the next 6 years with our candidate. So I think Senator Marcos was lucky that he was able to get Mayor Sara Duterte on his side, because then he also inherited that goodwill that is carried by the Duterte administration. And mind you, that has not changed. Even in the last SWS survey, that's a plus 60 and probably a 75 rating up to now. So I think, you know, this is how we need to analyze what's going forward. No? And then also, until October, people are guessing who's going to run. Mm. And then from October to November, people were guessing who is really going to run. Then when they found out who is going to run, Christmas came upon us. So it's been, you know, nothing has really happened from then until the middle of January. So you're just seeing surveys reflect what was in December. Mm-hmm. Moving forward, there are two stages of the campaign left.
Yeah.
The first stage will be where you try to compare candidates with one another. The last stage will be what we call the ground war. Okay. The ground war starts with the local campaign period. Why? Because that's when local candidates will have their rallies. They will be inviting candidates to join them. And generally, a local candidate will want the leading candidates to be on stage with them, because you know, they want to project the picture of a winner. Right now, we are in this, let's compare them stage.
Okay. Yeah.
And I think this is where we're going to do well. In our internal surveys, although our absolute rating has remained constant at about 6%, and, you know, Manny Pacquiao has remained steady at about 9, Lenny at about 18. And you know what these are actually the bailiwick votes. Like if you measure the Liberal Party vote and the Bicol votes, that's probably what Vice President's getting. If you're measuring the Cebuano votes, particularly in the areas that he belongs to, that's the Manny Pacquiao rating. Mm. Ping Lacson is the only candidate, I think, that wasn't a novelty in this election. He announced early. So there was no surprise when he ran. People were not really curious to know what he's going to do next. Okay. But everybody else, you know, you have a Manny Pacquiao who's a sports hero. He suddenly is running for president. You have the vice president who for many months was not presumed to be running for president, but rather for governor of Camarines Sur. And then all of a sudden, she runs. You have Senator Marcos. The Marcoses have a base of about, say, 15% to 20% nationwide, and they've had this ever since. It's they've never lost that. So that is the base that they come into this contest with. And then, of course,
And don't forget the base that voted for him as vice president, and that base that believes he actually won. There is absolutely that base too, right?
Absolutely. Yes, definitely. But as we can see from Vice President Robredo, you know, when you vote somebody for vice president, that doesn't mean that your sympathy will be with them for president, because you envision a different kind of person when you're thinking about the presidency.
So are you seeing that Robredo's votes, can Ping Lacson somehow get her votes? Is that, I don't think you have the same base.
Okay, in our internal surveys, in our internal surveys also, no, we are seeing that there is a ceiling for some of the candidates of votes that they can get. There are questions that you ask, like, okay, you are for this candidate, but if we ask you to consider Senator Lacson, would you consider voting for him, even if you're already with the other candidate? You know, in our surveys, we're getting close to 60% yes answer.
Really?
So, yeah, and then also when you survey, for example, when you survey his performance as senator, you're going to get nearly 70% approval. So we think people generally have confidence in Senator in Ping Lacson. They generally like him. You know, I mean, 70% of the people are not negative and maybe slightly positive. I think that's what we need to try to tap, because he is not the top of mind candidate for president for many people. They're not as enthusiastic about his candidacy as they might be for one of their idols, you know. But over time, and I think during this next 45 days, when debates will come around, interviews will come around, people will be asked about their platforms and their experience and so on. I think we're going to do well. And if you look at past elections, the period of time when high-ranking candidates who were topping the surveys started to slide down was this period, January to March. Why? Because this is when they really have to talk the walk and walk the talk. Okay. So you know, I'm looking forward to this next 45 days. I think our candidate is really going to be the best in this period.
Okay. Another question is Tito Sen, Senate President Tito Soto. Early surveys when he was up against President Duterte, wow, he was up by 20%, no? That survey actually made the president decide not to run. But then I've seen a survey that with Sara being his opponent, it changed the numbers. Do you believe Tito Soto can still beat Sara Duterte?
Oh, yes, absolutely. I think that's the contest.
Ronnie, does Tito Sen have beyond the surveys that makes you believe baka magulat ang tao siya manalong VP?
Well, I don't think that we have to produce something new. I mean, we just have to revive the interest and the enthusiasm that people have for him. You know, as I said, you know, in the period from October to to mid-December, nobody was talking about anybody else. It was really just the uncertainties of who was going to run for president, who was going to be vice president, and that kept, you know, the Marcos Duterte tandem in the top of mind of people. But I think that as we proceed again into the next period, no, in this election, number one, Tito Soto is not just an entertainer; he is a very deep thinker. He is knowledgeable about
all. He's a consensus builder.
Yes, he is. He will see this anywhere we go. I mean, there's genuine love for Tito Soto anywhere we go. So that's a benefit also for Ping Lacson. Because obviously there's a huge, huge base of sympathetic people out there. And we just have to touch them again.
Ronnie, so very quickly, you have been in so many elections, when it comes to the presidency, you don't think the race is over?
Oh, no, not at all. Not at all. There are a lot of factors that are present in this election now that wasn't here before. For example, 60% of the people are already on the internet. Although, of course, there's the 40% that aren't, no? 25% really do not have any signal at all. And 40%, at least when interviewed, said that they hardly use the internet at all. So that's a 60% base of votes. And most of them are, of course, on the intellectual side of our society. You have to craft your campaign in a different way now, okay, as opposed to before.
All right. We don't have enough time, so I do owe you another interview. But I just wanted to ask you quickly, what happened to you and Mayor Isko? Weren't you with him?
Well, yeah. No, I helped Mayor Isko on his run for the mayorship. We had a disagreement about the timing of when he would seek higher office.
I see.
Yeah. I basically preferred or was suggesting that he do 3 terms as Manila mayor and really change the city and make it again, you know, the leading city in the country.
Before
but he had
running.
Other plans, yeah.
No, kumbaga before running, tapusin niya muna yung ano.
Yeah, because he would only have been 55 years old after 9 years as mayor. And you know, 55 is a good age to become president. And you know, if you would already have been mayor for 9 years, you know, most of the problems of the country you would already have a good grasp of. You're not going to have to, you know, rush your studies and you know, biglang bibiglaan yung pag-aaral niya. No? So, but you know, I guess he felt that he was ready. So we disagreed on that and. That's why I felt I should not join that path anymore.
All right. Well, former Secretary Ronaldo Puno, I do hope to have you on Head Start again. With your experience, it's quite interesting to listen to just your point of view with everything you've already witnessed in your life, yes. Political elections. So I was going to say first, good luck. To Senator Ping Lacson and Senate President Tito Soto, sir. You take care.
Thank you, Karen. You too.